Hello everybody. Today we will see the fourth chapter, and in this fourth chapter the fourth unit or the fourth subtopic is the robots and robotics. So that we will be seeing. Now we can quickly go back that first in this chapter name is machine system. In this the first topic was conveyor. In that conveyor it was belt conveyor, roller conveyor, you may have seen. And then here you can see the first was can go back and see this is in this there are certain topics. The first is conveyor. In that conveyor it is belt conveyor, roller, chain and met conveyor, vibrating conveyor, pneumatic conveyor and the accessories for the conveyor. After that it was indexer and the synchronous. That is another topic. And then after that it comes out to be the part feeder, which also we have seen in the previous videos or previous recorded lecture. Now today we'll be just going through robots and the robotics. And in this one there are again different subtopics. The first will be the articulated robot, then SCARA robot, then Cartesian robot, then parallel robot, then a robot basic and terminology, and then a robot coordinates. These are the certain things we will be going through with this robots and robotics subtopic. So now let us see here the first things is the robots and robotics. We will see the introduction part of robots and robotics. The first is, what is robot? Is an electromechanical machine that can perform tasks on its own on the guidance, right? On its own or with the guidance. And industrial robots are used widely throughout the manufacturing sector. And the various category of these robots come in different configuration and the sizes. And basically these robots are most often driven by the coordinate servo gear motors moving directly on axis. However, sometimes that hydraulic robots are also there, and it is used in the some application. So this is one. Now after that industrial robot we can define is as per the ISO 8373 is an automatically controlled reprogrammable multi-purpose manipulator programmable in three or more axes. And in industry the term robot can be defined as the design and use of robot system for manufacturing. So in industry we are doing like this. And the most commonly used robot configuration are articulated robot that we will be seeing in the subsequent topic, then SCARA robots and the Cartesian coordinate robot, also known as gantry robot or XYZ robots. Then another thing in the robot is the main thing is the speed requirement, the position that must be attained, and the cost of the systems are factored that determine which type of configuration is generally used for a particular function. So this is the one thing. And then after that let us see about the articulated robot. The first type of robot which is much popular is the articulated. In this articulated robot is one that uses rotary joint to assist its purposes. Usually the joints are arranged in a chain so that one joint support another farther in a chain. So this way that robots are sometimes this articulated robot, another name is robotica. An articulated robot usually have you can say that anywhere from 3 to 6 joints. This is the example, or you can say that this is the definition of articulated robot. It is more than or 3 axis, or sometimes 3 axis, 3 or more than 3 axis, and it may go up to six axis, then it is articulated. And the this in you can see that this is one thing. Now articulated here, the another one more important thing is written, that is more than six joints are possible, but these robots generally fall into custom category. Another term of this is degree of freedom, defined as the number of independent motion that makes up the robot's area of operation. Either it can be, generally it can be 3 degrees of freedom, or it can be 4 degrees of freedom, 5 or the 6. Here the degree of freedom means there are 3 rotatory axes, so 3 degrees of freedom. There are 3 parallel axes, means you can say that movement in the x direction, y direction and the z direction. Then this type of is also possible, means joint can be 3 up to 6. So 6 matlab degree of freedom may be possible. Now this is all we have covered. Then more than 6 joints are possible, and just 1 second. But these robots generally fall into the custom category. Another term of defining robot is the degree of freedom, defined as the number of independent motions that make up the robotic area of operation. So this is one thing in terms of articulated. Here you can say this is robotic. So here is the rotary motion, and in this rotary motion, this also can rotate in any direction. And here there is a pick. You can say that this is again a rotary joint or semi-rotary joint, and with that, this picking arm is attached. Now, here you can see we can define the robot depending upon the joint. It can be J1, J2, J3, J4, J5, and it can be generally that J2 to J3 are usually operated in a vertical plane along with the rotation of J1. This allows the other point to be placed close to nearly every point within the robot program. Robots operating in VLOC, J4, J5, J6 typically act as a manipulator with the last joint. J6 usually being a rotary of which gripper or other device are attached. So these are the different sort you can see that robot. Now the next comes up to be this current. In SCARA robot, the first thing is, what is the meaning of SCARA? It is selective compliance articulated robotic arm. So that's it means it is a articulated arm again. So compliant articulated robotic arm, these are usually of the 4 axis with J1 and J2 being horizontal rotary joint to assess XY points. The another thing, J3 is Z axis and J4 being in a rotary or T movement of the end of J3. Now here you can see main thing here is this one. The parallel axis J1 and J2 is the end of vertical axis. J3 is rigidly controlling the XY position. Hence the term selective compliance. SCARA robots are widely used in the assembly operation than required in the assembly operation. So this is one thing related to SCARA robot. Now SCARA robot is less expensive. Before that, just you can see the example of SCARA robot. This is SCARA. दिस में मूव अप एंड डाउन डिपेंडिंग ऑन द सिचुएशन एंड बट दिस सेलेक्टिव कंप्लायंस एनालिसिस रोबोटिक आर्म दैट इज स्पैरा रोबोटिक आर्म इज अटैच्ड हियर. Now, we were in that J3 joint. Now, SCARA robots are less expensive than similar to than smaller size, fully articulated robot by virtue of the lower number of joint they possess. So, that is one thing related to SCARA. Then, next comes up to be generally this SCARA robot is also faster and more compared than Cartesian gantry system because the pedestal mount has a smaller footprint that can be multiple point mounted of a gantry. So this is right. Now here the meaning of gantry means it will be more than. Then it is called as the gantry. Now after that, in the escargot book itself, the Cartesian gantry system is also popular, and the students are asking. We should not. Here you can see. Now comes out to be the next is SCARA robot and then Cartesian. Here that Cartesian robot also called as linear or gantry robot has three linear axis of control in X, Y and Z direction. Now rather than having the rotary joint, the X axis is well mounted at both in with Y axis mounted on. Gantry arrangement are the simplest control scheme for robots since coordinates are in familiar X, Y and Z or Cartesian system and do not have to be converted to converted or interpolated as with the other system. So this is about the Cartesian robot. Now further in this Cartesian robot you can see what is the application? The first thing is Cartesian robot application is the computer numerical control machines. So here you can see, here this one is parallel that will come later. Now Cartesian robot, we were there, and the application of Cartesian robot is CNC machine, and these machines are used widely in industry for the automated machining of metal. This is about the Cartesian robot. Means it will not be any rotary joint and only that linear joint is there. Then there are three linear joints, means Z axis, X and Y axis separately. Then this is called as the Cartesian. Another thing, the next comes out to be parallel. Here the parallel robot is, the meaning of this one is that makes up of use of four or more linkages or kinematic chain from a central actuation point to an end effector. So that is one thing, that is about that parallel. Now when compared with the serial manipulator, here you can see serial manipulator such as robotic arm and SCARAs, the structural member are very light and therefore provide a much greater linearity. This is about the parallel robot. In parallel robot also, here you can see they have written Thank you. right? When compared with the serial manipulator such as robotic arm and the SCARAs, the structural members are very light and therefore provide a much greater leniency. That is about the parallel robot. The main disadvantage of parallel robot is that its workspace is limited. And a common use of parallel robot is the insertion of component into the PCB. That is another, you can say that further thing in this parallel. Now after that, this is the three different type of robot you have seen. The parallel robot, then Cartesian robot, then SCARA robot, and these are the certain thing you have seen here in this lecture. This way, this is one thing. Now after that, parallel robot, there are certain robot terminals. Here you can see this parallel. You can slide here and this can slide here. So first you control this one. If you are switching on this motor, this will slide in the Y direction. And if the company is switching this motor, this will go, this will be in the third thing, or the third you can say the direction. Now after that, certain robot basics and terminology related to it. So the main thing of this robotic system are made up of several components. The robot itself, which is motor, joint and the structure, makes up the moving part of the system. Right, now the another is motor and feedback cables are usually routed through the structural member of robot for the protection. So this precaution is taken by the government of India. Now, the motor and the feedback cables are usually routed through the structural member of robots for protection. The robot pendant is also used to write or edit robot program, as well as manually move the robot and teach position. Teach position means the first position. Then the terminology for robot and robotics can vary depending upon the manufacturer. Now to avoid that one, what are the things needed? Now here you can see the payload or the carrying capacity is the amount of weight that a robot must lift, including the weight of the end effector node. So this is one thing. And then another thing related to robot is the kinematic is the arrangement of rigid member and the joint as discussed. So this is one thing. Then after that, another is choosing between articulated SCARA, Cartesian or the other configuration involved determining the envelope of 3 points that need to be assessed and what assess and what angle, or you can say that in which way the they are taking the meaning of that. Now another thing in this one is accuracy and the repeatability. It is the accuracy and repeatability is the measurement of precision of any one. Then it is, you can say it is one thing. Then after that, the another terminology is the accuracy. It is the measurement of how closely a robot will move to a program or commanded position, while repeatability is the measure of how well the robot will return to the same position each time. So this way, these are the two different broad category for defining that accuracy. And then it comes up to be compliance. Compliance is a measure of how much a robot will move when a force is extended against it. So this is compliance. right? Now after that, the next thing related to this one is the a frame of tool frame is a coordinate reference that is used to allow an entire set of points to be translated to the new location. A singularity is a condition at which robot can reach a point through more than one joint configuration, making the axis redundant. And the singularity example we have seen are means that that was is already explained that what is the meaning of singularity. Here the right. Then next is how it can be defined. Accuracy, repeatability, how it can be defined. Now the American National Standard for Industrial Robotics means that robot system safety requirement of this thing NSI and RIA. R15.06-1990 define a singularity is a condition caused by the collinear alignment of two or more robotic axes resulting in unpredictable robot motions and the velocity. This is related to some terminology. Now it is most common in robotic arm that it relies a tripod wrist. That also is possible. This is a wrist about which the three axes of wrist controlling yaw, pitch and roll all passes through a common. This way it is another accessory in terms of ANSI, means that safety requirement and what other thing. Now, some singularity problem can be avoided by switching from partition mode to the individual joint movement within a group. Another method to slow the robot travel speed, thus reducing the speed required for the wrist to make the transition, avoiding the condition, sometimes referred to as a wrist flip. So, this is another thing related to singularity. Singularity, it is nothing but when the two joints member becomes straight and they are not able to move in a particular direction. So this is one thing related to singularity. Right. Now after that, next comes out to be robotic coordinate system. Here also the same thing. Various robotic control system, coordinate systems are there, and in this coordinate system, the first is robot movement and position can be defined in a number of different coordinate systems. Coordinate system applied to an coordinate system using the robot basis as the origin. Right, the tool coordinate uses the end of robotic arm where the tooling is mounted as the origin, and the workpiece coordinate uses a point on the work area tooling rather than a position of the robot itself as the origin. And joint coordinate describes the angular position of each of the robotic arm. This is one. Right, this is about the robot coordinate system. Then controller uses joint coordinate and perform mathematical calculation and interpolation to arrive at the partition point. And the last it is written that there may be an address in a programming variable such as J1 to JX, A1 to AX depending upon the software available on the software platform. So this is answer. Right. Now the next is another thing is robot robot coordinate system. This was the last. And this robot programming and the software is again will be addressed in the subsequent chapter. And with this, we'll stop here. Thank you.